listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is...
Hello, Year Two. This is Mrs. Chiswell speaking to you again this week. I hope you've kept yourself safe, and I hope you've enjoyed all of the home learning that we've been setting you. Miss Challis, Mrs. Gosling and myself have really enjoyed looking at some of the work that you sent us in your emails, but we would like to see lots more. Remember, the email address is year2@perfleetprimary.co.uk. Let's have a little look and see what our learning is for this week, week six. For maths, it's all about problem solving. That means you have to use all of the skills that you've learnt in order to solve word problems. And this week, the word problems are all about addition and subtraction. First of all, you have to read the problem really carefully and decide whether you need to add or subtract, and then think about which method or strategy will you use. Start off with a one-step problem and then see if you can challenge yourself to a two-step problem. And now we're going to have a look and see what they look like. I'm going to start off with a one-step problem. One bag of sweets has 20 sweets in it, the other 25. How many sweets are there all together? So we have to find out how many all together. So first of all, I have highlighted the numbers 20, 25. And I've also highlighted the word all together. And I know if I need to find out how many all together, I think, am I going to add or subtract? That's right, we're going to add. So this is going to be an addition number sentence. So looking at our numbers that we've got to add 20 and 25 together. Now I'm going to start with the largest number because it's easier to do it that way around, I find. And I'm going to start off with some jottings. So for 25, I've got two tens and five ones. And for 20, I'm going to draw two tens. Now I'm going to add up how many altogether. 10, 20, 30, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. So the answer is 45. Now I'm going to use a number line. 25 goes at the beginning. I'm going to add 20, so I'm going to do two big jumps of 10. So now I'm going to count on in tens. 25, 35, 45. Well, I've got the same answer. I'm going to try a third way this time. I'm going to use column method. And if you remember, with column method, we need to use our tens and our ones. And we're going to add. So 25 is two tens and five ones, and 20 is two tens and zero ones. Now with column method, we have to remember that we start with the ones column first. So I'm going to add these two digits first. So five ones and no ones, five ones. And then two tens and two tens is four tens, because 20, add 20, equals 40. And again, I've got the answer 45. So I've got 45, 45, 45, and all the three different ways that I've used. But I still haven't answered my problem, because the problem is, how many sweets are there all together? So now I'm going to write, there are 45 sweets all together, and I've answered that problem. Let's look at another one. I have 34 comics and I lend 12 to my friend. How many do I have left? Oh, we haven't got the word all together this time. We've got the word left. So I've highlighted my numbers 34 and 12 and I've highlighted the word left. Now if I need to find out how many are left, do you think I have to add or subtract? I have to subtract or take away this time. Now this time I do have to start with the largest number, because in a subtraction number sentence, the largest number comes first. So I'm going to start with 34, take away 12. And I'm going to draw my jottings. So it's three tens and four ones. Now I'm not going to draw 12, because this time, remember, I have to take away. So I have to take away one 10 and two ones. And now let's have a look and see how many I have left. 10, 20, 21, 22. So my answer is 22. But now I'm going to try another method. I'm going to try a number line. Now, because it's subtraction, I have to put my largest number at the other end of the number line, 34. And I'm going to take away 12. So I'm going to jump back one big jump of 10 and two small jumps of ones. So I'm going to start by counting back in tens. So 34, 24, and I'm going to count back in ones. 23, 22. Got the same answer. I think I might be right. But I'm going to check with column method. Only this time I'm going to subtract, but I still need to put in my tens and my ones. So 34 is 3 tens and 4 ones. 12 is 1 ten and 2 ones. And again, even if it's subtraction with column method, we always start with the ones column. So I'm going to start with these two digits here. So 4 ones take away 2 ones, leaves 2 ones. And then 3 tens take away 1 ten, leaves 2 tens, because 30 take away 10 equals 20. And if we look, I've got the same answer again. I've got 22, 22, 22. So I'm happy now that how many do I have left? There are 22 comics left. Those were both one-step problems. Let's look at a two-step problem. Jack buys 18 sweets on Monday and 10 sweets on Tuesday. He gives 6 sweets to Jill. How many sweets does he have left? So first of all, I'm going to highlight all of my numbers. I have 18, 10 and 6. And I've also got a word there that I've highlighted, left. Can you remember what we have to do if we have to find out what's left? Yes, we have to take away. But what do I have to take six away from? First of all, I have got to find out how many sweets Jack has bought all together. So he has bought 18 sweets on Monday and 10 sweets on Tuesday. So first of all, I have to add. And then once I know how many sweets he's got altogether, I then need to take away the 6 sweets that he gives to Jill. That's why it's a two-step problem. I have to add and then I have to take away. So let's have a little look. This time I'm just going to use column method, but you can still use number lines and jottings if you want to. So I'm going to start off by adding 18 and 10. The sweets that he bought on Monday and Tuesday. So here's my column. Got my tens and my ones. 18, 110, 8 ones. Add 10, 110, 0 ones. So 8 ones and 0 one. 8 ones. 10, add 10 is 20. So he has bought 28 sweets altogether. But now we know that he gives 6 sweets to Jill. So we've got to take our 28 and take away those 6 sweets. Again, I'm going to use column method. I'm going to subtract. So 28, 2 tens and 8 ones. And this time we're going to take away 6. Now 6 doesn't have any tens, but it has 6 ones. So 8 ones take away 6 ones, leaves you with 2 ones, and then 20 take away nothing leaves you with 20, so 22. He has 22 sweets left, and that's why we know it's a two-step problem, because first of all we had to add and then we had to take away. You have to read your problems really carefully though, because sometimes you might need to take away first and then add. Once you've had a look at those problems, there's a little mystery for you to solve, and it's called the mystery of the soft fruit. And for this one, you might need to do some addition or subtraction or statistics or weighing. You've got to look very carefully at the clues and see if you can find all of the answers. And all of the activities and resources are in this week's folder. In English this week, you have a story to listen to by an author called Simon James, and the link is here. It's called Dear Greenpeace. It's a story that's all written in letters, and it's letters between a little girl called Emily and an organisation called Greenpeace. Greenpeace helps to look after the endangered animals in the world and wants to keep the Earth's environment safe for everybody to live in. So in this story, Emily writes to Greenpeace to try and persuade them that she has a whale living in her pond in her garden. Now, persuade means that she's trying to make them believe that what she is saying is true by giving them lots of different reasons as to why she has a whale in her pond. Once you've listened to the story, you're then going to write your own persuasive letter. And you are going to try and persuade Greenpeace that you also have a wild animal living in your garden or in your bedroom. It might be a tiger living in your flower bed, or a monkey in a tree, or a snake in a window box, or even maybe you have a crocodile living under your bed. You can choose whichever animal you want. There are more ideas and resources in this week's folder, including some examples of persuasive letters. And if you want to listen to the story again, there's another link here which has the illustrations just a little bit more clearly for you. So I'm going to write a letter to Greenpeace, and I want to persuade them that I have a tiger living in my garden. Dear Greenpeace, I love tigers and I think I saw one in my flower bed today. Please send me some information on tigers as I think he might be hurt. Love, Mrs. Chiswell. Not too bad. Do you think Greenpeace will want to carry on reading that letter, or can I make it even better? Dear Greenpeace, I love tigers very much, and I think I saw a magnificent one in my beautiful flower bed early this morning. Please send me some information on tigers, as I think he might be seriously hurt. Love, Mrs. Chiswell. Well, this time I've added some extra vocabulary. I've used adjectives like magnificent and beautiful. I've told them when I thought I saw the tiger, early this morning. And I've also used an adverb, because I thought he might be seriously hurt. So which one do you think is best? The tickle pink, I agree. Enjoy writing your letters and see if you can persuade Greenpeace that you have a wild animal living in your garden or house. For science this week, we're thinking about another word, adapt. Did you know that animals and plants need to adapt to their habitat so that they can survive? If you want to find out a little bit more, there are three videos that you can look at there. And these are some examples for you too. Fish live in the water, so they don't need legs. So what do they have to help them move instead? Fins. An elephant lives in a hot climate, but which part of its body helps it to stay cool? Its big ears. A camel lives in a desert, but where does it store its food or fat? In its hump. These are all what we call adaptations. And once you've watched the videos, you're going to choose an animal of your own and draw it and write about how it has adapted to its habitat. Think about, does it live somewhere hot or cold or wet or dry? You could even write about more than one animal. Or you might want to choose how a plant has adapted. There's more information in this week's folder. This is a polar bear. Does it live in a hot climate or a cold climate? A cold climate. Now, this drawing of a polar bear has some labels like warm fur, thick blubber, sharp teeth. But you might want to add a little bit more information to your diagram. You might want to add some captions. So instead of just saying long claws, it says long claws for tearing apart prey. But whichever way you choose to draw your animal, you then have to write your information, saying how it has been adapted. I have highlighted some of these words because I think they're very good scientific words. You've got words like adapted, survival, camouflage, prey, climate, and diet. See how many scientific words you can use in your explanation. For reading, remember to try and read for 20 minutes every day, maybe before you go to bed, or if you're sitting quietly in the garden, or even in your bedroom. And don't forget to use Book Club. Then you're going to find out more about the continent and habitat of amazing Antarctica. There's a non-fiction fact sheet in this week's folder, and then you can challenge yourself to answer the 1-star, 2-star or 3-star questions. Now this week you're going to listen to two authors' books. First of all, we have an information book or a non-fiction book, and it's called Big Blue Whale, and it's by a lady called Nicola Davis. Now the second book, you might have heard of this author, she's called Julia Donaldson. Do you know which book she's famous for? The Gruffalo. But this one is called The Snail and the Whale. And we want you to enjoy that one this week. Have you heard of the French artist Henri Matisse? You will find more information about him in this week's folder in art. He's famous for making a collage called The Snail, and he used brightly coloured paper cut into different shapes which he stuck down. You're going to make a collage in the same style. This person made their own snail. But when you read the information, you will notice that Henri Matisse used lots of different shapes in his work. If you don't have any brightly coloured paper, then use your colouring pencils or crayons or paints to paint some paper first. In design and technology, you're going to make a whale. You could use a paper plate, toilet roll, an egg carton, or even just paper. There are links to instructions and ideas in this week's folder. This one is made out of an egg carton, or a toilet roll, or even a paper plate. And this one has been made by folding blue paper. Can you remember what climate means in geography? Remember, it was either a cold or a hot climate. And this week you're going to find out which animals of the world live there. Then using the links, you're going to find out about Asia and a city called Shanghai. Where is it in the world? And for history, who was William Shakespeare? And why is he a significant individual? Find out using the link below. Now Disney songs always make us smile, so for music this week we hope you enjoy singing along to this one, which is all about the habitat of the sea, and it is called Under the Sea. Then there's another song you might remember listening to in assembly. It's called What a Wonderful World. Dance along to the music and join in with the chorus. For PE, try and do your Joe Wicks workout every day. But remember, any type of exercise that you do is good for you. For well-being and PSHE, you're going to listen to a story called Be Kind. We talk about being kind to others a lot, but do you ever take time to be kind to yourself? You want to write down some ideas about how you can be kind to you. There is this resource in this week's folder, but you can always make your own. And then remember to try and do one kind or helpful thing for somebody every day and give someone a smile. Well, Miss Chalice and Mrs. Gosling and myself hope you enjoy all of your home learning for this week, and we would love to see some examples of your work. Remember to email us at year2@perfectprimary.co.uk. Well, goodbye year two. Keep safe and keep well. I'll speak to you again soon. But we're going to finish by looking at some of that fantastic work that you've been emailing to us. And if you listen really carefully, you might hear one of the songs you're going to listen to in music this week. Bye-bye.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here, all the fish is happy as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy. It's hard 'cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse of fate. One day when the boss get hungry,
yes, you go beyond the pay.
But no, under the sea, under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We what the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea, we after hook up. We got no troubles, life is the bubbles under the sea.
Under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to be here
naturally.
Even the sturgeon and the ray, did it, the earth start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. The newt play the flute, the cop play the hop, the plays play the bass and they sound the chop, the bass play the brass, the chub play the tub. The flute is the duke of soul.
Yeah.
The lay he can play the lings on the strings, the chub rocking on the blackfish. He sings his belt and his front, they know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow.
Music to me.
What do they got? A lot of sound.